Super Robo Taisen Alpha 3! It's your boy Zapki, the Giant Robots, and welcome back to Super Robot Wars Alpha 3. Wherein, previously, we officially recruited Firebomber into the team. We also nabbed Deimos, Tall Geese, Volts. Many, many good robots are in the team. As such, we have 17 squads. But we can only take 16 of them. Somebody has to sit out. Over here on Masu. Tigers having all civilians and non-combatants from Elysion evacuate to City 7, a process which will barely finish by the expiration of SBO's deadline. Apesos. This means that our squad will have to fight literally as though there is no tomorrow, given that our opponents are the apparently pitiless Imperial forces. Their previous incursion on Earth was a bid to utilize our espers and various forms of super energy for themselves, as well as to stem the disruption of the humans posed to the Galactic Order by using those powers for military purposes. Oh, there he is. Cosmos supposes that the Empire, who are doing much the same thing with their powers, think that they're in the right, and muses that even without their intervention, the Earth seemed destined to implode from its own infighting anyway. What he's seen, any people who would dare carry on some internal conflict with the vast war power arrayed against them probably ought to be destroyed anyway. Armro, in fact, has to stop this very infighting between Cosmo and Ryoma before Ryoma beats that ass. And he and Taiga agree that there's very little chance that our lives will actually be guaranteed should we actually surrender to the Empire. What's more, if we surrender, we are sure to be used as a part of the invasion of Earth itself, either as hostages or combatants. And Duo very well remembers how good the Empire is at brainwashing. When Gamlin tries to put Mylene at ease over the daunting prospect, Bossra shows up and tells him that he'd better learn some less corny lines if he wants to win her heart. He blows off Gamlin's furious repose and tells a rather incredulous Cosmo that he fully intends to make the Empire hear his song and thereby stop them from fighting. Cosmo is very skeptical. Meanwhile, some of the more level-headed crew are trying to figure out what Ganlan's deal is. Kusaha believes that the Chokijin, which has a mind of its own, ought to have resisted Ganlan's joining the Imperial forces. And Bullet agrees, saying that Ganlon's actions could only endanger the world of men, and even if he's an Esper, he should be able to entirely have his way with Chokijin. Camille says that, though he's loath to admit it, this may all add up to Ganlon's thoughts and actions actually somehow being connected to protecting the Earth after all. Bullet is then forced to remember the painful scene where Ganiden proclaims herself the Lord of the Chokijin, on that his and Kusa's machines disobeyed her orders. However, Bullet says that Ganiden is also gone, and that had he and Kusa done the wrong thing, there's no way Edie would have tried to come back to them. Plus, there's the fact that their machines sacrificed themselves to protect Kusa and Bullet, and indeed all of the Alpha numbers. Thus, Ganlon cannot be in the right. Kusaha is sure that the mystery of Ganiden's connection to Chokijin is contained in whatever reason is making Ganlon's machine obey him. Over on the enemy side, Ganlon points out to Epeso that his little broadcast surely won't make the humans surrender. Nor was that Epeso's intent. Indeed, should the humans surrender here, it's proof that they couldn't withstand the battles to come in the Empire's future. And Ganlon professes amazement at the Empire's Byzantine strategizing, though he adds a caution that even plants can wither if watered too much. He then says that he was hoping to participate in the next battle as a token of his fealty to Epeso and Hazar, nervously laughing that he has no ulterior motives. Epeso gives him a mighty shrug, figuring that no scheme of Ganlon's could hurt the Empire, despite Ganlon's protestations that he merely finds the Imperials interesting. Stage 25. Ebareshimono, Ebareshimono. Oh no. Erabareshimono, Erabishimono. The Chosen, the Chooser. Countdown 5 minutes until the conference with Epeso, and only 1 minute longer it will take to finish the evacuation. Unfortunately, to protect City 7's retreat, we have to put our ass on the line here. Everyone must put out to their balls and go all in. So the question here is, who's sitting out? I think looking. I think I'll take burning and you can sit out. Or no. Yeah, okay. Now that one gets to sit. Wait, okay. I think if I just cancel this, I need to put a piece of equipment on the Gulliver. I should have more dust proofs. Oh, hello, Mega Booster. Nosky Craft, you say? Ah, shit, I forgot about that. Yeah, I need that. Okay. Wait, then what part of your group is stuck on the ground? Who can't fly? Kaiser can't fly? Really? That's something. That will definitely increase your movement. No, we're hanging on to those. And who can I give a Minoski craft to? Whomst would it behoove? Like, what group? Oh, you transform, so that's fine. Where did it go? Okay, cool. Sick. Ah, all four of our boats are in. Excellent. And all of our fighting is going to occur down here. It's all in that area. Just some squads need to be in the back row. Everyone summons their courage, including Kira, who seems to be pass fretting about naturals versus coordinators. Yeah, now's not the time to worry about that shit. The Empire shows up in due course, bringing their flagship along with them. Our squad's answer is, of course, unchanged the last time of the ball. Since the time of the Balmar War, becoming his pawns is the last thing on our agenda. Epezo deigns to call this foolishness on our part, but Shingo knows full well that if we surrendered here, it would hardly stand us in good stead with the Empire. Evacuation completes, just in fucking time. Goodbye! But it's up to Melby, Erica, and the others to look after the civilians. Epezo cares not that the civilians have escaped. After all, he's after the skilled fighters and their advanced weaponry. Getting long talking shit. Clear the stage in 8 turns. So, all the badasses are in the middle. That's a boat. Gotta mine that map. Right? Let's start with... Oh, that's not the move. Catra, you will recover that 1 SP. Oh, these don't have maps. They have all. Okay. This one has the map, though. Noted. So the idea, according to book, is to split left and right. And then converge on both sides. Trading sides. Okay, let's Oh, man. Man, everybody on team four. Oh, that's just multiple people. Hello. Focus is good enough. On the next turn, I'll throw. No, I'm saving disturbance for when it's time to punch a boss.
するな。持たせてみせる。
Okay, then let's send you this way. Oh, if I can. Yeah, do it. Oh yeah, hot blood for Goldie. Morale up. Yeah, it's good enough. Put that music on.
Shikara de neji fuseru no wa ore no ryugi ja ne. Toshiki Love Heart.
Cause Goldimar sure as hell needs that morale up. Or we'll never see the move! Baby! Put on that other good shit? Why did it change? Why did it change back? Do I have to do it every map? Okay, it's that one. Thank you. Okay, now that reset it. Hold on, I need to figure these out. There's just no permanent... There's no permanent setting for it, which sucks. Oh well. One of your songs have morale up. Yes, morale up. Good. Focus.
System attack! Ike! Sound us! 13! Disk B! Set on! Token the sound! Kikasete yaru tte!
Level 140. Okay, well, we're halfway there, at least. Voltaz needs to be in the lead today. This one. Side now. Oh, you ended up over there. I need to move you. It doesn't matter. They can converge. Level up that prevail. Why did I almost call it morale? Fizz Code, level, defense level 3. Alright, hopefully, following turns won't take so long. Levels up. Barriers. We want levels up. Gene gets prevail level up. bowed up. Okay. I acknowledge you. But you have to acknowledge this. Alpha. Right. Okay. Okay. Does hot blood? God, I need to throw some trust around. Oh, yes. The time of doom approaches, sir. Boat fight! Then
Gaga
ーが破れたわけではない。
Prevail level 4, support attack level 2, and now we have hammer time. Excellent.
こいつでとどめだ。よし、やれ、りょ
Invincible, very good. Benk. That's nice. Encourage, hot blood, flash. Something's getting picked up by the microphone. I don't like this. I don't know what's going on. Something was activating the microphone when nothing was going on. Maybe I can figure it out in post. Maybe the microphone is picking up static or something. Let's continue. Focus. That's actually less accurate. That's what I didn't want. Boats are hurt, Voltas. Gatter's on the other side. But yeah, this side's really been hit. Nice! Two levels for Ko. Got through the barrier. Hot one for Miwa. Shield for Zex. I almost called it Trays. Oh, I think. Everyone's gonna get hit. Invincible flash. Nope. Oh. armor down. Good. Damn, that was way too late. Try. This is what could hurt. I'm gonna run it. All right. Definitely need to get him healed. That actually broke through your defense last time, so... up. got for healing over here? Not a whole lot. And power. Excellent. What do y'all got? 47. Nope, get back in the air. Remy, Hot Blood, Lock, Invincible, Guard, Invincible. Flash of Inspiration. Bazooka. Strike through. Support attack? Yeah, she does. Okay. Oh, because you're not flying. Thank you. Alright, alright. Lock, guard. I know I'm burning all my stuff before I need to, but... Right, this is the boss. Pacing. I still have the entire other side, though. I'm not doing too bad.
さて、盛り上がっていこうじゃないか。
Can I reach? Yes. Still have invincible. Good. You know what? Take it. Fine. 49. Definitely want to get him with all the good numbers. Support attack plus one. What do you got? 44. Zex, what do you got? 42. Get on the floor. Ah, 55. Okay, that's the number I needed to see. Flash. That bless. Okay, we need. Motivation. Delete this man.
Lightning Smasher!
僕を超えているのか。君も念者なら僕の力がわかるだろう。じゃあフィナーレと行こうか。
いや。Oh, I didn't protect the whole team. Fuck it, that's fine.
Target Rokun. Kochira kara mo kon. Target Rokun.
Doken.
Aijo kashi.
That was the triple, so I have good faith. But that's dynamic kill. Hell yeah. And that's a biocomputer. Big numbers. Prevail level 4 supports hack level 2. TK level 3 support. Prevail level 3. Oh no, those are level 4. It's SP plus level 5. Ganlong, with his ass beat, says that both he and his Chokijin are amazed at how well Bullet is able to do without a Chokijin of his own. Gusa asks if his Chokijin is going along willingly with whatever Ganlong has planned, and he says, of course! Noting that he's known his mech for far longer than Kusuna knew her real Oki. He also adds that he'd like to think that he has a better idea what the Chokijin actually are. A better idea of what the Chokijin are actually for than our people seem to, telling us to swing by his place anytime they want to know the truth. It's worse, Kusuha, making her wonder whether her and Bullet's machines were actually lying to them. Surely not, right? And he buggers off. Goodbye! Asshole. Oh, these seems to have more HP than Gamlon did, I think. Oh, hi, Judo! I completely forgot I switched you out into that. Damn. Okay, that's that half of the map. SP. Beast mode. And then... Oops. Yours is the cheapest. Okay. I need to fix it, then I'll fix it. What if though? Fine. Alright, someone in that crew's gotta have an XL. Kia and Prevail Level 5.
クロス
カウンター Excellent. Prevail level 5. Flash. Prevail level 5, sword cut level 3.
Hot blood.
Prevail level 3. Boat over. Not want that. No. Brave before. All right. Let that boy rest. Destroy them. That's eating up all my energy. I need to stop that. That's fine. It wipes out all the grunts. No way! Damn. I could have used that for burning. Alas, alack. Think we'll be alright. Yeah, come on, turn the Ideon on. There he goes. The almonds are activated. And defend. Bonk. Bonk. Have moves, you have a resupply. Alright, that's a plan. Move boat. So, did I give you the movement skill? Yes. Good. Excellent. You don't have a thing? Oh, but you have barriers, though. Shield level 3. Not that you're using a shield. Ever. Huh. New type level 4, sword level 3, sword level 3. Full volley! Turn we on? Am I wasting time? I'm kind of wasting time. Oh. y'all don't have Excel, do you? There it is. Catra. Why don't I have you with the resupply power? Cause I'm stupid. Damn it, some of my plan banked on that. Oh well. Excellent. Upside now. Can I? No, hold on. My friends. Hold on. Let's do a math. Okay. 46. That's the gauge on how much we're gonna get. Chizuru has 46. I saw SP8, morale up. She gained nothing. So only main pilots? Damn, okay. Noted for the future. Next time use it on Getter. Our heal bot, okay. Sounders, Jusanse. Okay, can't reach Getter, but nope. Not what I wanted. We'll be right back. No. Not, we're not going to start that just yet. Hot blood for real. I hate that you have regen. Fuck off. Take this drill. Barriers. Ha ha. Damn it. Out of range. Out of range. Shield level 3 for Basara. Thought one of y'all would have had. Oh, there it is. Oh. No, don't do that. Do this. and this.
But
that's your armor down, though. Still cannot perceive. Let's assess. That's an all. What can I do? I wonder if everything retreats if I delete shit. One. Nice. Remy gets hot blood. Killy gets inspiration, probably. Hell yeah. I didn't need to turn that on. Fire Blaster! Not good enough. Damn terrain. Finally, hammer time.
Gordian Hammer! Hatsudo Shouni!
Yokai! Gordian Hammer! Safety device! Deep!
Makarita! Gordian!
の差を理解しておらぬようだな。
Damn, not quite enough.
弱者には死を。それが宇宙の原理だ。
Do I have anything left on this turn? Anybody close enough? Excellent. Whew. Once we beat down Epezo enough, he comments that our prowess, which took down the 7th Fleet, is surely worth serving the Empire. He says that both the Thundergate and our squad need to persevere in order... Damn it, this is happening too fast. Slow the fuck down. He says both the Thundergate and our people are needed to preserve order in the universe, and says it's going to take some time to see precisely how far our power extends. He unleashes a Zephiel, the self-organizing memory alloy cells that gave you such bits back in the Bombard War. It watches, it learns, it evolves, it even makes Julianne Fry out of our squad. The disturbing part is that the previous Zephiels we fought were all humanoid, presumably from fighting all of our anthropomorphic mecha. This one is not. Pezo tells us that to ready our hearts for the good, for the god of creation to visit his wrath upon them. Misato cautioned that this is surely not the bad guy's true trump card, given the timing. Even if the First Fleet were now facing the same strength as the Seventh Fleet, and there are at least five more battleships like this one we were just fighting, each with a Zephield on board in all likelihood. She tells us all to wipe it out as fast as possible, since there's no telling what will happen if it lingers. Pezo's looking forward to getting his hands on the swords the Thundergate has chosen, all for the sake of the Empire. So, is that just a full recovery? What kind of numbers are we looking at here, dog? Let me read this dang book. Okay, 75,000 HP. And I have no skins that could have analyzed it, so... Time to see how we are! Roll the dice. How bad is it gonna be? Oh, no map?
弱者には死を。それが宇宙の原理だ。アルドレーザー、照射。各グレンキャノンは弾幕を厚くしろ。よし、直ちに反撃を。熱いぞ。敵に捕捉された。先に仕掛ける。ミサイル発射だ。
Barriers,
you say? Somebody needs to avoid that. Not that. That works. Take this armor down. Support attack? No, not yet. You're not even ready. That again, 47, yes. Show me your move.
Ikuzo, Ayato Benkei. Sama ni mo ajiwawasete yaru. Getta no osoroshisa o na. Sona! Sasha!
世に歯向かうか。愚かな。受けよ、アルドレーザー勝者。
受けた、おかずに戦う。やるな。
こちらからも攻撃を行う。射線上から離脱せよ。結末は見えているのだ。
Boy. Go up on them, no one gets inspired. Let's yeah, you need to go.
でも暗いな。勝負どころだ。
に決めようぜ。
抜かるんじゃないよ、忍。
お前たちの命、俺が預かる。
関空工学園、やってやるぜ。
結末は見えているのだ。世の裁きを享受せよ、心せよ。銃の神罰が今何時らに下る。受けよ、リベンゲバウト。
やったな。
ああ、なっちゃいないね。
あら、てめえは一言多いんだよ。
奴らにこのマクシミリアン・ジーナスの戦い方存分に見せてやる。敵部隊をマクロスキャノンにて殲滅。
了解。カウントダウン開始します。
エネルギー注入完了。
マクロスキャノン発射。どうやら世は汝の力を侮っていたようだな。帝国観察軍の名にかけて汝らを滅する。アルドレーザー照射。相手の動きを読み切った。
Excellent.
Thank you.
Oh, I don't have anyone that can back that up. Right?
Right.
Well, good thing I tried to go all in anyway. Time for safety save. That would make it. Dang bears. I guess that's that prevail kicking in. Come on! Really? Come on! It's crackling. I finally heard it. So this didn't get me anywhere. Unless... maybe this will get me somewhere. Right. Because Amelia can do that. Nope. That's not according to Keikaku. Didn't like that. Not a fan. It's been a battle of audio issues. Once again, different issues, but if that works, then perhaps. Hmm. That's a sure hit. Okay. No. Single. Dang it, I wanted to watch him go down too. Fuck me. Now this game's over. I'll cut back to it. There, go down. There, give me your money, give me your Haro, give me your X, available for, raisable for, skill point get, give it to me, got stuff to do, got food to eat. This field is worth a regular ass Haro, a peso, now rather singed and apparently in failing health, is visibly sending our data to the Empire to make them stronger. Misato suspected. Epezo was in fact disposable. He growls that he's the faithful vessel of the Spirit Emperor Ruoff, and tells us all the chosen swords that our true enemy is in the galaxy. As the field explodes, remaining Imperial forces leave, which there are none. Lamar's area, our crew gets a full unpleasant taste of realizing that this victory simply raised the curtain on the next phase of fighting. Got far too many enemies arrayed against us, too, and too many questions about why they're all active at the same damn time. Add to that the mysteries of the Ide and Zapawa. I don't know what Zapawa they're talking about, but sure. It is clear that various strange things are afoot here for the Alpha Numbers. Daigo points out at the very least that we have saved Mars and will have to go on solving the problems immediately before us for the time being, the next of which being a showdown with the Primevals. Deep out in space, at Ye Golden Palace. Janella hears that the Empire is withdrawn from the solar system. Sanbajil? Yeah, sure, why not? Marvels at how low the Empire, once rulers over the Boazan, has sunk, and Janella figures that the Empire, for all its strength and diversity, has also grown brittle from overexpansion. Sanbajil figures that they may be able to retake the Campbell at this rate, but Janella isn't in a mood to forgive Warcomedes and Dangle for their blunders on Earth. Dangle begs for another chance, but Janella zaps him before berating him at length as imbecilic morons and the dumbest at that. I'm not using the word that the author wrote. Zamajil cuts her ranting short, pointing out that their own army is also repeating its failures on Earth. What this really means is that he's got more dirty work with the two fuck-ups to do. Janella warns him that this time they're either going to come back having fulfilled the Alliance dreams, or be processed as low-fat dog food. Zamajil states that their enemies aren't only the Balmar on Earth, At the moment, the biggest threat is the Muge Empire. Muge's Armados. These beings aren't rightful dwellers of this plane, much less the galaxy, and although they are supposedly allies, he fears the repetition of their past humiliation unless he can figure out what the Muge are really up to. Especially showing that they seem to have vanished from the Earth sphere and severed communications. Zanbajil doubts that the setback on Earth could have affected them that badly. In any case, he agrees with Janela that the time has come to smite the Empire and restore the rightful galaxy nobility to power. Or so he thinks. Another part of deep space. Ruaf reports to Shiva that the data from the first fleet looks quite fascinating. We're sacrificing one of the Judeca Gotoso types. Judeca Gotso types, and is a field to obtain. Ruaf dismissively says that there's any number of replacement dolls available, and orders a Pezzo's data transplanted into one of his clones. He may still have his uses. And Scylla points out that the Alpha numbers seem to have added Ideon to their number. Quite a wild card that's also a part of a certain person's plan according to Ruaf. Or perhaps a sign that they've been preempted. The Alpha numbers are, after all, a very special thing within the galaxy. The assemblage of ultra-powerful weapons and warriors, with espers and psychics at the helm, cannot have come together by mere coincidence. Though Ruaf doubts the Alpha numbers realize it themselves, he feels a strong sense of purpose, as did Ganiden and Shiva's former puppet Yuzes. Maybe even Armana felt it, in which case Earth might actually be their original homeworld and not Balmar itself. That would explain why the Room of Gauf tried to open there, and why the Gods of Destruction are attacking an otherwise backwater world instead of the center of the Balmar Empire. But the entire previous life of the Balmar Empire may have risen and fallen on Earth. Not that Ruaf cares much for what happened in his past empire. He tells concerned Scylla that to let Armana do as she pleases with a little bit of time left to her, noting that Baran and Rulia have been assigned to protect her. In any case, Ruaf plans to simply watch the solar system from afar for now, and concentrate on the battle with the Buff Clan and the Gods of Destruction. Scylla plans to put Hazar, Saldes, and Hiradelia on the case, noting that the Boazan seem to be stirring up trouble. Ruaf lets Shiva reorganize the army to fortify its overextended defensive lines. They move on, with Shiva reporting that no progress has been made in understanding the cross games, assuring Ruaf that there's no need to intervene lest something happen to him himself. And Ruaf smirks, sardonically thanking Shiva for his loyalty. Scylla has something to report on the unlimited energy front and makes haste to prepare a ceremony for Ruaf to communicate with the Zafields. Ruaf says that this will be a long session given the end is nigh and whatnot. Shiva thinks to himself that he'd rather get moving if he wants to get his hands on the key and dislev. Ruaf, meanwhile, figures that it won't matter what the humans do. A new time will begin, and he'll be alive to see it. Get a bunch of free items. Whew. Next time. Video games. And I don't mean playing video games. I mean we recruit video games. Good night, Space Lords.